We have all seen the planetary model of our solar system since back in our school days. The planets are shown to revolve in a nice circular path, forming concentric rings, with the sun sitting smack dab in the center. While this vision of planets following a nice circular path around the sun looks neat and tidy for a school project, in reality, things aren't that simple. The planets in our solar system don't really revolve in perfectly circular orbits. Instead, they generally have a stretched version of a circle, which is technically called an ellipse. How stretched, you ask? Well, that all depends on the orbital eccentricity that the planets possess. Too much mathematics going over your head already? Well, let's get the basics down first. An ellipse is a symmetrically shaped, closed oval. It has two points, called foci, which act as a combined center for an ellipse. This ellipse has an important property called eccentricity. Simply put, eccentricity tells how much the ellipse deviates from a perfect circle. Mathematically, the value of eccentricity varies between 0 and 1, with 0 representing a circle and 1 transforming into another shape, called a parabola. For planetary objects, when orbital eccentricity crosses 1, the planet no longer remains confined to the star, and it escapes from its gravitational influence. Now, let's focus on another question. How much of an elliptical path do planets in our solar system actually have? Or, technically speaking, what is their orbital eccentricity? Well, as you can see, it's quite evident that the orbits of most planets aren't very elliptical. Mercury is relatively more elliptical than the rest, yet it is still closer to zero than it is to one, meaning that it is closer to a circle than to an extreme ellipse. To those wondering what an extreme ellipse could be, there's a great example to look at: Halley's Comet. Halley's Comet follows a path with an eccentricity of approximately 0.97. Just look at how elongated its elliptical path is. But the question still remains, why aren't the planetary orbits perfectly circular? Well, for that answer, we need to go back in history. For a long time, from Ptolemy to the age of Copernicus, it was widely believed and accepted that planets revolved in a perfectly circular path. This was until Kepler came along and laid down important laws pertaining to planetary motion, with the first one being that planetary orbits are elliptical. But why elliptical? Well, in an ideal universe, all orbits would have been circular. In fact, some orbits are perfectly circular, but those instances are very few and far between. For a perfectly circular orbit, the orbiting planet would need to have mass, velocity, and distance from the star that precisely matches the gravitational influence of that star. A slight change in any of these variables would derail the planet from maintaining a perfectly circular path. For example, if the mass of a star or planet changes, or any other celestial body whizzes past that planet, it would disturb this delicate balance of mass, velocity, and distance that keeps a planet in a circular orbit, and it would therefore change it to an elliptical one. Even a small tweak in these status quo conditions or any interplanetary interactions would change the path from a perfect circle. Despite fretting about orbits being not perfectly circular, it is worth understanding that these orbits are still closer to being circular than they are to being highly elliptical, which is perhaps why the planets we see today have survived the test of time. Planets with highly elliptical orbits are more likely to run into trouble as compared to a circular counterpart. Why is that? Well, think about it like this. The planetary model taught in school, consisting of planets following circular paths, naturally stacks one planet above the other without crossing the path of each other. However, in a case when planets have a highly elliptical path with varying eccentricities, those orbits are more likely to cross paths with one another in potentially catastrophic ways. In short, this makes planetary bodies more susceptible to collision and impacts. In the aftermath of an impact, a couple of things could happen. One is that both the colliding objects could break and disperse off into pieces, or they could simply merge into a single, larger entity. Many astronomers believe that this sort of activity has been happening in our solar system for billions of years. Planets that exist today in our solar system aren't the only ones that have come into existence since the birth of our sun. However, they're probably the only planets that have endured such massive cosmic impacts. The nearly circular orbit with which 8 planets in our solar system revolve has certainly helped them in their quest for survival.
If you like this video, then please leave your comments below and subscribe to our channel for more animated stories on the science in our lives. Also, don't forget to hit the bell icon to never miss an update from us.